Choosing a college is a big decision, and there are so many different factors students and parents need to consider that it can be overwhelming. But there are a few things that can help you make that leap from high school to college and make that leap just a little easier. And the campus college visit is a great place to start. We're joined this morning by Ann Sandoval, Director of College Counseling at Detroit Country Day School, and she's here with some advice for students and families who are planning their college visits. Thank you so much for joining us. So is there best time of year, for instance, to start visiting colleges?
Well, you know, they're earlier in a student's experience. For example, when a student might be finishing eighth grade and they're about to enter high school, starting to visit a variety of schools, perhaps starting in your own local area.
And what does that do, starting locally?
Well, you know, for example, as I drove up to the station today, I noticed Lawrence Technological University. In our own area, we have a variety of schools. Some of our students, you know, would benefit just from being on a college campus, going on an organized tour. Mm-hmm. The more experience and more information they gather over time, the easier it is going to be to make those decisions in the future. And then perhaps widening that band beyond your own community, maybe further out in the state of Michigan.
So before making the investment to go travel to schools that might be far and wide, you were suggesting that you could actually do a little bit of some of that preliminary legwork locally, even if it's not a school you intend to commit to.
Right, because you're gathering information, you're knowing what to look for when you go on these guided tours, which again is something I strongly recommend, is you go on various college websites and go under the admissions or prospective students, and you'll find information about making a campus visit or a college tour. And you'll be able to see the dates and the times, because having an organized approach to that visit, you're going to gather the best information rather than just wandering around not necessarily knowing what you're looking at.
And one of the big issues that people have to contend with is, do I want a small college? Do I want a large college? As a final question, how do you guide students to choose what kind of college they might be best for them?
Well, we want them to be open-minded. You know, again, depending on where you're at, if you're a freshman, sophomore, be very open-minded. Mm-hmm. Understand, you know, what an experience might be at a small college versus a large comprehensive university and colleges in between. The further on in your education, as you become a junior and certainly a senior, you've narrowed your focus. You might know what academic major you're looking for. So some colleges may no longer be a fit because they may not offer architecture or engineering. So the more information you gather, the better off you're going to be in your future to make those important decisions.
Ann Sandoval, thank you so much for your guidance. And of course, we'll have more information on our website, WXYZ.